So we are talking about electricity, and today we are going to discuss about Ohm's law. Let us see what is Ohm's law. So, in 1827, a scientist named George Simon Ohm, who found the relation between the potential difference and the current. Let us see what he stated. In 1827, a German scientist named George Simon Ohm found out the relationship between the potential difference and the current I flowing through in a metallic wire and the potential difference across two points of a metallic wire or its terminal. So I repeat, in 1827, a German scientist, George Simon Ohm, found out the relationship between the current I, which is flowing in a metallic wire, and the potential difference of its terminal. According to George Simon, At constant temperature, potential difference V is directly proportional to I. Potential difference V is directly proportional to I. At constant temperature, V is directly proportional to I. So, this Ohm's law is all about only two things: potential difference and current. At constant temperature is also very important thing, because if temperature is varying in any metallic wire, then this law is not valid. This law is only valid if temperature is constant. So at constant temperature, V is directly proportional to I. Okay. If we remove this proportional, we have to add one proportionality constant, and here we put a proportionality constant which is resistance, which is resistance, which resist the flow of electric current. See, V upon I is equals to constant, which is R. Now we are able to write V is equals to IR. So when we remove this proportional, we have to add a proportionality constant. This proportionality constant is resistance. Okay. So resistance is a property of current which is resist the flow of electric current. Okay. See. Now, the SI unit of resistance is ohm, which is named of a scientist who discovered it. Okay, so ohm is a SI unit of resistance. Okay, so it represent in a Greek letter, which is this letter, and this is ohm. Okay, so we have to remember it. See, Ohm's law, V is directly proportional to I. Now V equals to IR. When we remove this proportional and we add this proportionality constant, then we get the value, the formula of R, which is R equals to V upon I. So when we say that in a current carrying circuit there is a 1 ohm of resistance, it means that 1 volt of potential difference across two terminal of that circuit and 1 ampere of current flow through it. If the two terminal across 1 volt of potential difference and 1 ampere of current flow through this conductor from positive to negative terminal, then we say that there is 1 ohm of resistance. Okay, so now from first day of this chapter to this, we have 3 important formula. First is I is equals to Q upon T. Second, V is equals to W upon Q. And third, R equals to V upon I. We have to remember these all 3 formula, which are very important and required for solving any numericals. So I equals to Q upon T, V equals to W by Q, and R equals to V upon I.